In this workbook, I've had some buttons on the right. These buttons are being associated with specific macros. Click, for example, this button and look at the results. So, when you create a macro, you might want to have an easy and effective way to run each one, like a button. You cannot expect users to open the code window and run it. You can use a button, a scroll bar, or whatever form control you want, and assign a macro to it, a macro you've already recorded. When the control is clicked, the macro is executed or played. The first step is to highlight the Insert tab. From there, we can insert a shape, a rounded rectangle, for example. Nice! Now click the drag, somewhere there, and the button is ready. If you like, you can change some of the formatting options, like text fill or text effects. We are ready to type a name into this button. Great! The second step is to right-click and select Assign Macro. A new window box appears. We have a macro called Line Chart. Select and click OK. That associates the macro with the button. To try it, simply click on the button and look at the chart. Another way is to associate a macro with an image. The steps are exactly the same. From Insert tab, click on Live Pictures, for example. Type in Line and choose this image. Right-click as before, assign macro, choose this macro, and OK. Fantastic! We managed to associate a picture with a macro. One final note, if you have lots of macros, you may end up with buttons all over your workbook. This can be really messy. So the idea is to put all your buttons on one sheet, with descriptions like a control panel. It will make your life easier for sure. Thank you.